I would tell you, was as complete a performance as we've seen in recent years from a guy where there were some uneven moments with him lately.
Well, unfortunately, in boxing, sometimes, you know, boxing media and fans, we judge a person based on how they've looked lately. And lately, Valdez has looked good. He hasn't looked great. But in the totality of his career, he's been a really good fighter. But he crossed over from being a good champion to a great champion tonight. And I don't throw that word great around very easily, but he's a two-division, two-time world champion, and he beat that guy. And it's not that he won, but it's how he did it. He boxed beautifully before the knockout came. You got to tip your hat to him. Yeah, he was a smaller man. They said he couldn't punch. He figured it out, and that's what champions do.
That was an all-time great performance right
there. It was.
That knockout right there, I have to tell you, that was knockout of the year. I don't think anybody's going to top that, because it was against the boogeyman, the baddest man at 130 pounds, Burchell, and Valdez wanted this challenge. I told you guys, it's a difference when you want to do something than when you're forced to do something. No, you don't want to be forced to run 4 miles. No, you want to choose to run 4 miles. Yeah. It just feels a lot better.
He was motivated by doubters, Timmy.
That's exactly what it was.
The president of Mexico was FaceTiming Miguel Burchell yesterday to wish his rival well. President of your country is wishing the other guy well and picking the other guy.
But, you know, sometimes that negative attention, you know, can drive a fighter and drive a person.
Bulletin board material.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, you take that and you listen to that crap, and then you let that thing motivate you, and then you come out and you prove all the doubters and haters wrong.
Plus 650 was Valdez by knockout. Plus 300 was Valdez to win. But everybody said, no, the fight will not go the distance. It was an overwhelming minus 250. Look at the smile. He's calling family. The celebration will go deep into the Vegas night. Mark Kriegel, your final thoughts.
The president doubted him. His idols doubted him. And now he has made idols of kids back in Mexico and also in the United States. It was a victory for his bravery. He beat the bully. It was a victory for composure. It was a victory for Frank Espinoza, his manager, who brought him to Eddie Reynoso, who gave him the technique to complete this victory. We have really typecast Mexican fighters as just warriors. He was anything but that tonight. He had grace under pressure. This is a great victory for Oscar Valdez.
You're right. He was everything tonight. Grace under pressure. Victory of bravery.
I want to thank God for this opportunity for me winning. And I said it before, there's nothing better in life than proving people wrong. I have a list of people who doubted me. My idols doubted me. Boxing analysis doubted me. They said Burchell was going to knock me out. But you know, I got a message out there to tell everybody. Don't let nobody tell you what you can and can't do. Always work hard. If you're disciplined in life and you try to do your best, you know, you stay disciplined, anything is possible. Don't let anybody tell you you can't do something. Always prove them wrong.
We all thought you had to fight the perfect fight, that you had to stay focused the entire time. How were you able to pull off this upset against the most feared puncher at 130 pounds?
A team, you know, it's a lot of teamwork. A lot of time is being smart and disciplined, staying focused. And there's a lot of distractions out there. It wasn't easy training with a pandemic, but like I said before, just always try to go for your dreams. Don't let nobody tell you you can't do nothing. Always train hard, do your best, try to always be number one. Nothing's impossible. So I said it before, there's nothing better in life than proving people wrong. And I think my team was a big part of this. I want to thank my father for being with me since day one. You know, I want to thank my family, my trainer, Eddie Reynoso, my manager, Frank Espinosa, my cousin, Bubba, you know, Nassim, Dr. La Madrid. I got a list of people who I want to thank. You know, I can stay here thanking a lot of people, because it's not a one-man sport.
And you know what? That list is what we all saw in terms of flaws of Miguel Burchell. His other opponents, the six men who tried to take this belt from him, also saw it. What did you see, and how were you able to take advantage of those flaws?
You know what? I don't know. Every time I would see him, I would say, I think I could beat him. You know, and I know it's going to be hard. But I couldn't be in life. I don't want to ever be in life 60, 70, 80 years old and have regrets. Say, I should have done it. I should have fought him in my prime. So that's why I wanted to take this test. And thank God I made it. Thank God I accomplished my dream. Thank my team. Thank everybody who supported me. And thank everybody who said I wasn't going to make it. But you guys were a part of this. You guys were a part of me training harder to prove everybody wrong.
Now, you said that this was going to be one of those Barrera-Morales fights and that you were going to inspire the next generation of Mexican fighters. How do you think Mexico feels about Oscar Valdez right now?
I hope they liked it. There was a point where like Armechet was wanting me to stay in the inside the ring, and there was times where I did want to stay in there and bang to give a good fight to my crowd. Even though I didn't do that a lot of times, I hope they liked it. I'm so happy right now. I can almost do a backflip like Teofimo Lopez.
What does this win do for your career, and where do you go next?
I don't know. I trained so hard for this fight. I've been training for 4 years since the pandemic started. I want to go back to my family. I haven't seen my family in a long time. Just want to go and hug them, thank them for being the best part, the best thing in my life. I was going to take this belt back home, and I'm happy for that. Any champion out there, I heard Shakur Stevenson wants to fight. Let's do it. I just want to keep on fighting and give the fights the fans what they want.
Congratulations, guys. Viva Mexico.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus.